Today we are very proud to launch the 24-hour safety net program at NU hospitals in collaboration with an MOU with Masimo. What this exercise means is that every patient will get monitored 24/7 throughout the hospital, irrespective of which ward they are in, whether they are in the general ward, or twin chair or single room. The difficulty that we have is that once a patient gets moved out from the operating theatre or the ICU, when they move into the wards, the regular monitoring is not there. The continuous monitoring is not there. And therefore, the nurses monitor them only once in around 4 hours. There is a chance that a patient may deteriorate during this gap, which may require them to be shifted back to the ICU, which will entail a lot of costs. And at the worst case scenario, may also have a death on bed type of scenario. So by monitoring them continuously, these sort of events will definitely go down and the patients will hopefully get discharged much quicker. The costs of which are not too much. It should probably be anywhere ranging between 500 to 2000 rupees a day. And for an average patient that stays in the hospital for 2 to 3 days, if we can avoid a stay in the ICU by 1 day or avoid a patient deteriorating and ending up with a lot more clinical care, the savings would be immense. So what this simply means is that there is a small probe that is put onto the finger and a monitoring device captures this, and this is transmitted over the internet and over the intranet through Wi-Fi throughout the hospital and is centrally monitored. In the event that there is an alarm, say for example the oxygen saturation is lower, then there are paging devices that go off for the doctor and the nurse so that they can take immediate corrective action. When this happens in both our hospitals, both at Rajaji Nagar and Padmanabh Nagar, we will be the first hospital in the country to have all the 160 beds monitored continuously, and we hope to launch this approximately maybe 2 months from now.
This would be an instrument that is sitting on the patient's bedside, right? And you have measurements like SpO2, you have pulse rate, you have hemoglobin, you have other measurements like, you know, pleth variability index and so on. And this would be connected to the patient, and all these measurements will be done. Yeah, all the measurements will be done from the patient. And all these measurements are going to be shown on a central station, which is kept in the nurse's station. So at the nurse's station, nurses can see this central monitoring station. And this is the bed that we are monitoring here. From here, this is the parameters that are shown here. Now, how the system works is, if something goes wrong and if the patient has a problem and the oxygen saturation in his blood comes down, then you have this number going down from 96 to, let's say, 88 or 89. That will initiate an alarm, and which will be seen here on the station, and which it will also be transmitted to a pager that the nurse carries. So if the patient gets into a situation where some intervention has to be done, then the alarm will be initiated and you can start responding to the alarm. You can come in, probably start oxygen or do any interventions that are required to prevent the patient from going into a critical situation. So by this, we can actually save the patient's life if you are able to early detect the problem much early, so that interventions can be initiated much early.